As you probably know, the finger is a pretty useful tool if you're trying to operate a remote or a light switch. I wonder if there's a way to automate a finger in Home Assistant. Let's find out. This is the Fingerboard Plus. It is a Zigbee device, and inside the box, we'll be able to find the fingerboard, and that's it. If you really want to search a manual for it, you'll need to scan this QR code and also find a few setup instructions on the side of the box. Before operating this unit, on the back, you'll find a small cap that you'll need to take out. It's pretty tight in place, but once open, you'll find a pull tab that you need to remove in order to activate the battery, and the device is online. Put the cap back in. Let me align it. We are ready to go. One thing to take into consideration, the board will usually sit on the side like this, and once activated, it will trigger your light. For a light switch, you'll need to have two boards, one that will turn on the light and one that will turn it off. It's not possible to have both functions on the same unit. In Home Assistant, if we go to Zigbee to MQTT, on the bottom of the page, you can find the fingerboard already added. It's a straightforward add-on, nothing special to do. If we click on it, we can see that this is an end device. It exposes, we can find information about the battery, and the most important thing, the mode. Right now it is set to switch, which means that on a command or a button push, it will press the finger, and on the next command it will release it, or we can switch it to click, and this mode is basically the default mode in which it will push and release on a single command. Once this is done, we can do some simple automations, settings, automation and scenes. I have created here a test automation for the fingerboard. This is a hold action, so that means that if I hold the button pressed on my Zigbee button, then it will toggle the fingerboard. This is a very simple automation, just as an example. You can do, of course, more advanced ones. Since this device is dirt cheap, basically, I think it's worth it to purchase one and use it in locations in which you do not want to replace your old switches or have other types of jobs that a fingerboard can do. Well, that's it for this video. I hope that you found it useful, and if so, please don't forget to like and subscribe.